Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install WAMP server on a Windows operating system. And then I'll also show you how to create a simple hello world program on PHP and how to run them in our WAMP server. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of WAMP server, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in that this bar, just you need to simply search with WAMP download, WAMP server download. And you'll be getting this, you know, sourceforge.net as our first source result. So just simply click on WAMP server download. And here you can just, you need to just simply click on this download button to start downloading our WAMP server. So, you know, after 5 seconds, it is going to start downloading our WAMP server, and see, it has rightly started downloading our WAMP server. I'll be putting this link in the description, so you don't need to worry about, you know, what link you'll get the WAMP server. So not a big deal. Now, since I have already downloaded, I'll just simply cancel it. Okay, I'll just simply minimize my browser. I'll just simply go to my download directory and see our WAMP server 3.2.6, which is the latest version as of now, is already been downloaded over here. And the file size is almost 600 MB, so it is 596 MB. Okay, now to install, you need to just simply double click on it, and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory. And you can see our WAMP server installation wizard rightly opened. So it is currently asking what language you'd like to choose. So you have English or France, these two languages to choose. I'll be choosing English. Then just simply click on OK. And this is our license agreement. Just simply accept this license agreement, and then just simply click on next. And see, these are all license agreement. Just simply click on next. And here they're going to create our WAMP folder, which is WAMP 664. Okay, so just simply keep this default. Just simply click on next. And here they're going to install, you know, this WAMP server Apache, then PHP 5.6, and also, you know, the latest version of PHP, which is PHP 7.8, and all those things they're also going to install along with our MariaDB, MySQL. Okay, so you need to just simply keep everything as a default. No need to select anything. Okay, just simply click on next. So they're going to create this WAMP server 64 folder, which is totally fine. Just simply click on next. So, you know, it's ready to be installed. Just simply click on install, and there you go. Our installation has rightly began. So this installing WAMP server will take some time, you know, a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after completion of this installation. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our WAMP server is almost installed. But before that, it is asking whether you'd like to use Internet Explorer as a default browser. So for which, you know, I don't want to, you know, use Internet Explorer as a default browser. So I'll just simply click on no. And it is also asking whether you'd like to use Notepad as our default browser. So which is fine, but I'll just simply click on no. And it will going to, you know, finish up installing the final process of WAMP server. See, about 30 seconds left. And as you can see, it has rightly installed. So just simply click on next, and 3.2.6 is rightly installed. Just simply click on finish. Right. So now that you know that our WAMP server is rightly installed, and you can see that our WAMP server icon is also created, all you need to do is you need to just simply double click on this, you know, installer, and then just simply click on yes. For, you know, providing administrative privileges, it might show this type of error. Just simply click on OK, and you'll be seeing this icon WAMP server. So just simply click on that icon. It will turn to yellow, and after some time it will turn to green. See, it has turned to green. So all services are running. It is also showing all services are running. So it is our server has rightly started. Now it's time to, you know, go to our C drive, and here, as you can see that our WAMP, you know, 64 folder is already there. Just simply go inside that folder, and you'll be getting this www folder. Okay, so this folder will be using to communicate with our local host server. Okay, so this www folder is very important for, you know, WAMP server. So all you need to do is just simply click on new folder, and let's give the folder name as php_practice. Just simply go inside that folder, and let's create a new, you know, text document. I'll be giving this name as hello world. and I'll change this extension with .php. Okay, just simply click on yes to change the extension. Our hello world.php file is right located. Just simply go inside that, you know, file. And here I'll be writing a simple PHP code snippet. So angular bracket PHP. I'll just simply, you know, maximize it so that you can have a better visibility. And I'll be simply echoing hello world. Okay. Hello world. That's it. Just simply go to file and save. Okay. So now all you need to do is you need to just simply go to our browser and here just simply type localhost. Just localhost, hit enter. And you'll be getting this WAMP server homepage. Now you need to give a slash after, you know, just a slash after localhost. And now just go back a folder. See, we have created in www folder, we have created this PHP practice folder. So you need to simply copy this folder name. Okay, then just simply go to browser once again and here just simply paste that folder name after localhost slash that folder name, then hit enter and you'll be getting this folder rightly, you know, shown over here. Remember, on this PHP practice folder we have created this hello world.php where we have written a simple PHP code snippet. So that hello world.php is rightly shown over here. You need to just simply click on that file over here and see hello world is rightly shown. So if you edit anything, like let's say, you know, you change hello world to hello everyone. Okay. And you save this. And now if you refresh this page, you can see hello everyone rightly shown. Okay. So in this, we can easily install the latest version of WAMP on a Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.